I am Ullas Parlikar. I finished my BTEC in 1980. Then I did my master's from IIT Madras. And then I joined Hindustan Liver. I was there for 5 years. Then I joined Bombay Dyeing Group. I was there for 9 years. And then I was with ACC. I was there for 23 years. And then I retired in 2018. And since then, I'm acting as a consultant. A lot of people feel that I can do something, and whatever I do, they feel happy about it, probably satisfied. So, and I keep getting, you know, things to do. That's the interesting aspect. By design, I am a scientist. Mm-hmm. In the sense that you know, when I was about to finish my master's, there were a lot of opportunities that were coming, but somehow I was stuck to doing research only. And I was very happy that Hindustan Liver flew down to interview me and select and take me back. And that's how my scientist journey started. And then there were several things that happened in the course of my career. All kinds of activities, starting from research to technology development, to scale up, to commercialization, to project management, to business development, and subsequently managing the business. And somehow, you know, I got involved with wastes because I felt that there's nobody who is doing much about wastes. And I felt there's an opportunity. And while I was working and trying to do something in that area, luckily Holcim took ACC. And Holcim had a very strong pillar in utilizing waste as resources in cement manufacture. And they opened up, you know, all their knowledge to me. And that helped me to gain a lot of insight into this aspect of waste management. And I was able to, you know, very fortunately and also very enthusiastically work in this particular area. And do a lot, you know, very, very, very satisfactory work. And that also helped me to get into new areas of activities, you know, advocacy. Advocacy was something which was absolutely unknown to me. But this particular field gave me opportunity, and then, you know, actually getting into corridors, bureaucratic corridors, trying to influence them, getting like-minded people together, devising a strategy for advocacy, you know, a scientific strategy for advocacy. That was something I was able to learn and do it because of my mental, my scientific attitude. And I was able to publish some papers also on that count, you know, how this can be done successfully. And now, you know, I am fully, as I said, into consultancy areas. But with a lot of, you know, scientific mind, although I worked in cement, currently I am also trying to help the power generating industries as well as steel industries to substitute their fossil fuel with waste materials. And they are very happily taking it forward. I know that, you know, it's going to be a successful thing. Basic idea is to reduce the carbon footprint. So that is what I have, you know, a big canvas in front of me. And I want to write something which will help do that. And in that respect, you know, whether it is steel, whether it is power, whether it is cement, those are the areas in which how new things can be done to reduce the carbon footprint. Because a lot of industries have announced their aspirations that they would like to become zero carbon footprint companies, you know, by 2050 or 35 or 40. But I felt that there's no roadmap, trustworthy roadmap available with them. And I feel that, you know, this is something which needs to be provided to them. And that's where I'm working on. And I believe it will be a very successful venture because the results are, you know, always positive. That's my take. apart from doing this, you know, I have always been, wherever I traveled, and I used to travel a lot, wherever I travel, I will always go to an institute to make a lecture to the students, because my philosophy was, if I am able to influence at least one or two students from every institute that I visit, that's good enough for me, because they will start working in this area with the same mindset and passion that is required for doing success. So everywhere, you know, I would find a 50 students class, a lot of them uninterested, but that never demotivated me. I was looking at people who were smile and who had, you know, bright, big eyes, looking forward to what I was saying. And those were the students, you know, who I liked, and most of them keep in touch with me. And they do a lot. I mean, they're contributing a lot in wherever areas that they are. What I can bring, of course, you know, I do not know what I can bring, but I know for sure that there's a huge talent which is here, which can do a lot, and which can also extract a lot from what I have as knowledge or capability or whatever I can, you know, provide to them. So that is what I feel is something which is available for me to contribute in this particular group. I have always loved the team with which I am working. I feel they are pretty interesting, very, very enthusiastic, very motivated. And I believe, you know, they will do a lot, because whatever they did so far, it has been exemplarily good. It was remarkable, you know. I never thought that they would come out with something as good as that. And that is giving me more energy and motivation to work with them and see to it that, you know, they will come up with some very bright ideas. They're very, very interesting things happening around me when I'm interacting with them. So that's the thing as far as family is concerned. My wife was a teacher. I have a son who did his master's and PhD from Carnegie Mellon in artificial intelligence. And from Carnegie, he was working with Amazon. Suddenly he found somebody who wanted to start something new. So he decided and he shifted to India. He operates from India now for the last 6 years. And then I have a daughter. She is a medical doctor. Then she did her PhD in psychiatry in Nimhans. And that's how I'm moving to Nimhans. She has finished her PhD. Now she is going to do fellow, postdoc fellow she has started.
Okay, no G and all. Okay, I am just Ramakant. Okay.
I just needed that permission.
To start with, who am I? I feel I am proud that I am a chemical engineer. I joined chemical engineering for the sake of chemical engineering. So I changed jobs just because I found what I am doing in that area was not really adding my value as a chemical engineer sometimes. So that's how I describe myself. And I donned many caps, including I passed out from OUCT in 87 and then joined IISc Bangalore for my master's and continued for PhD. I joined University of Malaya for postdoc for about 2.5 years. I was there and then came to India for teaching at B.V. Razu Institute for about 2 semesters approximately. And then I moved back to Singapore for a project where I had to work with on university industry tie-up project. Why I had to go quit teaching, though I love teaching, I had to quit teaching because one part, like thermodynamics, chemical engineering thermodynamics, I couldn't explain or convince myself why we are reading this subject, frankly. That's something which really struck me. I said, what is, if I cannot get convinced, how can I teach my students? So that's when I realized I don't have industrial experience. I should probably take a little bit of experience in the industry and explore how chemical engineering is being used in different industries, and then probably a little later in the life get back to teaching so that I can impact them much better. That's how I stopped, I moved out of teaching. Then I went to Singapore for NUS as a project, for a project which we were working on with the DuPont Singapore. It was a purely a project that develops a simulation software for part of their existing plant to improve their improve the productivity and things like that. So that's how I also got into understand the nonsense of what simulation is. Okay, that's when I got to know about the simulation Aspen Plus, and then how, okay, somewhere underlying is some thermodynamics involved. That's what I just started realizing. And then I came back because of some family commitments. My father was not well and things like that. So I started as a scientist in IICT Bangalore. But soon I moved to software development where it was chemical engineering software. Like it was Pro 2. Am I there?
Yes,
am I
sir.
Audible? Somewhere, I think. Okay. Okay. Yes. So I was software development engineer in Pro 2 for about 4 or 5 years. And then went to GE as an application engineer for the Pro 2 to develop cross the power related part of the software in Pro 2. So that's how my journey with I was still in I kept myself in touch with chemical engineering so that I don't miss out on that. I really quit software because suddenly I realized the models that I am developing, I will not be able to see them in the next decade, one decade or even more, because the by the time they get into the design and then become a plant and a reality, it is like almost 1 to 2 decades. That's what I realized, and then I said, no, this is not I should be doing. So I should be doing something much much more where I can see more results in the. So that's how I went into the application part, and then in GE we were working on some power related software development, power related designs basically. And from there I realized that though GE was there, it was a little bit the group itself had some sort of no innovation inside. So that I talked to my manager and told him my concern that in this group I don't see any innovation. So because of that, soon we will all be disoriented, and then within 2-3 years all of us will get bored with the job. So let us do something more. But they had different plans, so I had to move out gracefully. And incidentally, after 2 years, that group was dissolved because there was not much output from them. Okay, so I went to a smaller company where which sort of led me to realize some part of my dream, which like applying chemical engineering mathematical models, where we were selling a mathematical modeling tool called GPROMS. Okay, and we were the only people who were selling in India. So I used to help. GPROMS is a modeling tool which can be used both in industry as well as in teaching. And that's how, like, for about 3-4 years I was there. And then I had to return back to Hyderabad. for some other family problems. So I came back here, and after some time, I worked in Dr. Reddy's labs with the API as a process expert. There, yes, I was able to. I feel nice when I say that I was able to identify some problems. Like, for example, there were mixing problems in different in when they scaled up. Okay, so I understood what was the problem, and in different 3-4 different areas they were failing. So I gave them a map or how to overlap what exactly needs to be done, what we should see before we take up a set of mixing speed in the reactor to get the same kind of product that we are getting in the lab. Okay, so I after 3-4 about 4 or 5 I could solve them immediately, and then I gave a template based on that. For next 3-4 years, absolutely there was no mixing related issues in the entire plant, not just one plant, all across all the plants. So that is something which I felt very nice, and then I moved to the formulations group. There also was able to crack some of the problems which were bogging them down, and in the first attempt, and that's how that's where I was able to contribute whatever little bit from the understanding. Since I am from IAC, we were trained IAC. We are trained hard in the sense we are trained to look at whether a pipette will deliver exactly 10 ml. A 10 ml pipette will deliver exactly 10 ml, or does it deliver 9.8 ml? Okay, that kind of thing. So my senior used to come and ask, okay, how do you know that it is 10 ml? So I had to find an answer. Okay, so then, okay, then you'd say, if you don't know, let me explain you. You can easily weigh the volume of the liquid that is coming, and then you will get more accurate results. Volumes you can weigh only at the most up to 0.1 ml, 0.1 or 0.05 ml accuracy. Whereas when you measure, the same thing, you can go up to 0.1 milligrams, that is 0.001 ml. So my senior, we used to have a very good interaction during our time. We used to discuss each other's project and then question their assumptions, their results, and then what exactly. So that's how in those about 8 years of my IAC period, I felt it was like a golden period, because it taught us so many things, including being patient. That's another thing. So I feel at peace in any kind of situation. I don't really get excited much. So that's where that's probably one good thing, or sometimes it could be bad. As of now, I would take it as a positive way. So this is my background, and now right now I am doing my independent consultancy. My main aim of doing this is I want to bring the change about the way the API are being developed in India, in Hyderabad, in India, wherein we are not looking at the development of these chemicals from the engineering perspective. They are being developed based on the chemistry, and in many places they are using statistical methods to develop a reaction, which I feel is very criminal to the chemical society. So that's where I would like to bring the reaction engineering approach to the development of chemicals, which it could be much useful. That's what that's my goal. I'm sure I'll be at least making a good dent in the industry in the next few years. That's what is my target. Okay. So apart apart from that, I don't know how I'll be able to contribute. I am willing, I am open to taking questions, solving, and then whatever help I can do. I am willing to teach chemical engineering or any subject in chemical engineering or otherwise. So that's what I can give to the group. So not to the mentor, that's good for me. To the mentees, some to students, anyone. Okay.
I guess if I have to start with what I am, I would say I'm happy and peaceful. And who I am is something that, as Geeta said, I'm also trying to uncover rather than search. I would say it's more of uncovering, and it's been a wonderful journey for that. And that journey itself has brought a lot of happiness and peace. So for that, I'm very, very thankful, grateful. So that's partly the affiliation with the gratitude. Now, with a more mundane definition in terms of who I am, I was born and raised in Hyderabad, and I'm number 5 out of 6 children in our family. And the only happily and joyfully single one out of the lot. And so right now, all the mentees are my kids. Well, they are my friends as well, but they are my kids too. So that has been a lovely, lovely experience. And of course, Shravan has been kind of the Bhishma Pitamaha of this whole enterprise. And it's just been such a wonderful journey. I'm also otherwise known as the classmate of Geeta and Shravan. And so that's part of my identity. For a lot of these kids, I think that's how they probably know me. They also call me Mashu for various reasons. I won't go into the story here.
Okay, now I understand who's... I was trying to understand through the messages saying Mashu, and I'm like, what am I missing in this? Now I understand. Okay. Though I don't know what does that mean, but I know who's Mashu. No, at least.
Well, history is long, but I'll just tell you in brief that in Kerala, or in Malayalam rather, the term Mashe means sir or teacher. But a lot of the kids felt it was too formal. So kind of like changing Geeta to Geetu, they changed Mashe to Mashu, just as an affectionate pet name. So that's how it got stuck. So right now I serve as the principal in Amrita School of Engineering, Bengaluru. And I am trying to put the PAL back into the principal. That's part of my role here. And because it's been a very, very challenging environment, I would say, that I've faced of an environment where the administration of education has been with enforcement and fear rather than with love. And so that is something that I'm trying to change. Then in terms of my experience, well, it's got a combination of chemical engineering, statistics, and sociology, and have a love for sustainability, especially sustainability that has a foundation of spirituality. And so that is my interest, and in whatever way I can contribute, I'd be happy to. As of now, I would say the mentees have taught me more than I've taught the mentees. So it's been a blessing. Thank you.
So this question, who am I? I actually have started asking this question only in the last 2 years. You know, I've understood this question. I knew who I was, but anyway, that's a deeper thing. That's a different conversation. But my name is Geeta Vemparala. I have 2 children, a 26-year-old girl and a 23-year-old boy. I see myself as someone who is constantly stepping out of her comfort zone at the risk of looking like a fool to many people around me. I've done it over and over again. And yeah, I have been a fool too, but it's okay. You know, I've come to realize it's okay to do that. As far as what I do, I'll tell you a little bit about what I have done and then where I am now. I worked at UPS for close to 16 years as an environmental program manager. This is where my love affair for the environment and Mother Earth began when I was close to 25. I then left the comfort of this job and did a couple of stints at AT&T and an insurance company for close to 11 years. Only recently I quit my insurance job. Now I'm on a quest to build my coaching business, helping women who are going through relationship issues, specifically in their marriage. Women who are victims and survivors of domestic violence, you know, that could be physical, emotional, and or financial violence, abuse. I'm a divorce and transition coach. As far as what I bring to this group, from an entrepreneurial perspective, I think I'm here to learn. But I do have, just to box the value I bring in, I have extensive experience in the compliance arena, both the environmental and outside of environmental, establishing compliance programs. I feel every growing company should start paying attention not only to, you know, succession planning, but also to instilling company values in employees, you know, by weaving them into their daily operations and not just in their annual training, you know. So that's what I did, you know, in my previous jobs, weaving these into their daily operations, not something as a to-do. So through this compliance framework, we build a solid foundation of ethics, integrity, and compassion within the company. This in turn, I realize it fully promotes and supports a gratitude mindset and a learning mindset for which ESOL stands. So I feel that's the value I bring, but I don't know, I may bring in something else that I'm not thinking of, I'm not aware of. So that's who I am.
So hello everyone, I'm Sunanda Gundavachila. What should I say about myself? I call myself a loving and caring person. I find it very difficult to say no when somebody asks me for help. And I put my family first before anything else. I try to be around for them for what is needed. And in terms of what are the things that I do and how do I do, I like to write. I love reading. I also blog a little bit. I'm a project management enthusiast. I have written a lot of articles about project management and I try to put that into practice. I love working with students. I have been doing that in different contexts. I started off with the PMI, the local chapter, working with students, building their competencies, building leadership. That is how I also connected with the activities that Shravan was doing, because I feel it is important that we bring out the potential in them. There's a huge potential. And the selfish side is when we are working them with them, we feel very energetic, very enthusiastic. So that kind of rubs off. So that's the best part about it. I want to help people. I love doing that. And I reach out in different sectors. The hearing impaired sector is one area that I was working with and I continue to work with, helping them in terms of the projects that they do. Because I feel whatever the project management or whatever we are talking about, when it is really applied in those areas, or let's say in the grassroots level, that is when the sanctity comes. So these are some of the causes that I would want to work for, and I try to do those things. Another thing is I have two boys. One is a 29-year-old, ready to go to Canada for doing his MBA. The younger one is already in US. He's completed his master's and working. He's about 24 years old. So I've been in Hyderabad for a very long time, right from time I was born. Not much of a travel, but I would love to travel and explore places, especially those with the historical importance. That is something that I like. Now, coming to what I do. So I presently am working as the director of operations for DispatchTrack, which is a software product company. So as part of that, I have actually gone through the complete setting up of the operations in India, including working with the ROC and then understanding the procedures, processes. So everything from scratch. So that is something that I can say I bring as value to the table, to the organization, because I'm now aware of all those things. The other thing that I have done is there were a lot of ways in which I have evolved. I have made changes. I've taken career breaks 2 times, and then I have again come back into the mainstream. So I believe that is one thing that I have, being flexible, being adaptable, and, you know, taking different roles. I started as a chemical engineer, but then I moved into IT as a project manager, then into training, consulting. Then again, now I'm back into heading the operations. So there's a lot of variety that I have done, which is something that I feel there is a learning mindset which I can bring to the table. And of course, project management is something that I believe in, and I can bring more value to that. And the network that I have built through the project management community. Yeah, that's about it.